Good morning, dear class 10 students. Dear students, let us continue the civics first chapter with the topic the Union Parliament. So the Union Parliament, which we call it in Hindi Sansad, it is in New Delhi, and this is the place where the parliament members such as Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha, as well as president, they all come together here and they discuss about the political issues, political rule and regulations, and also they prepare all the laws and orders for the country. So in Union Parliament or the Union Legislature, the three main bodies are found. Basically they are President, two houses of the Parliament, such as we have the Lok Sabha, which we also call it as a People's House, and the Rajya Sabha, which we call it as a Council of States. So these are the three main bodies of the Union Parliament. In a democracy, people are their own masters. So in a democracy, people are the masters of the country. That means they are actually the real owner of the country. Ours is a representative democracy where people exercise their sovereign power through their elected representatives. So the people themselves elect the leaders, and these leaders, they are there in the post as a post of prime minister, as a post of cabinet ministers. These all are provided by the people, and these all posts, the certain leaders they get through the elections, that is Lok Sabha election as well as the legislative assembly election. So the parliament is the body of people's representative who have supreme power of governance in a democratic country. So parliament is a body of people, because the countrymen only they elect the leaders among themselves, and these leaders are there to rule the country, but ultimate power of the country belongs to the countrymen. Lok Sabha. The Lok Sabha is the house of the people. So why it is called house of the people? Because in the Lok Sabha, the ministers are directly elected by the people. That means through the vote of the people, the representative of the Union Parliament, they become the Lok Sabha members. The members of the Lok Sabha are directly elected by the people of India in the Lok Sabha election. Like we talk about Narendra Modi, the Prime Minister of our country, and many more ministers who are sitting over there in the parliament, they all are directly elected by the people, except the Rajya Sabha members. But the Lok Sabha members are directly elected by the people through the voting system. Now term, according to the constitution, the term of Lok Sabha is 5 years. Okay, that means there are so many political parties in our country, and whichever political party wins the Lok Sabha election in a big majority, that particular party is given the chance to administrate or rule the country. So that means the constitution, sorry, that means the Lok Sabha also, or the parliaments also, after the new election, we could see that the parliament session takes place for 5 years under the leadership of a new political party who has formed the government in the center. However, it can be dissolved, it can be cancelled before the expiry of its normal term by the president on the advice of the prime minister. So, the Lok Sabha or the parliament session can be dissolved. Dissolved means can be stopped or cancelled before the expiry of its 5 years term, and that happens due to the certain reasons, such as when the ruling party loses its confidence to rule the country, and when any ruling party member or the minister caught in any corruption, and if it is proved, and when it is proved, then also the whole administrative body, that means prime minister and then his, we'd call the colleagues, they all resign from the post because of the one person who has not followed the policies and then the rules and regulations of the constitution, and in that case he is removed from the post, and then because of that person the whole ruling party body also has to resign from the post. During the proclamation of an emergency, the period of Lok Sabha may be extended by parliament for 1 year at a time. So whenever in the country any emergency takes place, either it is a external war, outside war, or either it is a we'd call the internal we'd call the revolt, or when there is a financial crisis of the country, then the Lok Sabha session may be extended 1 more year. That means that tenure will be of the Lok Sabha will be, we would say, 6 years. But if the things are taking place normally, or things are happening normally in the country, then there is no any matter of extending 1 year. Then the Lok Sabha runs for 5 years. The new Lok Sabha must be elected within 6 months after the normal emergency is lifted. Now, composition. The maximum strength of Lok Sabha as provided by the Constitution is at present 552. Out of this, first one, not more than 150 members shall represent the state. So, these many parliament members, especially the Lok Sabha members, they represent the different states. That means from different states, these many ministers are the member of Lok Sabha. Number two, not more than 20 members shall represent the Union Territories. And from the Union Territories, only 20 members supposed to be given the membership of Lok Sabha. So only from Union Territories, the 20 members are allowed to become the Lok Sabha member. And third one, the 2 members of the Anglo-Indian community may be nominated by the president to Lok Sabha in case he feels that this community is not adequately represented. So, 2 members they are appointed by the president and they belong to the Anglo-Indian community. So these two members also, they represent in the Lok Sabha on the behalf of their community. The allotment of the members to the various states is made on a population based. So according to the population of the different states, the allotment of the Lok Sabha member is given. Like you can see here, Uttar Pradesh is having biggest populated state of our country, and that's why it is having 80 Lok Sabha members in the parliament. And for Rajya Sabha, we would say 31 members are there for the Rajya Sabha. And in other states, according to the population, you can see that the member for Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha are elected or appointed. Uttar Pradesh, as it is written also, Uttar Pradesh is represented in the Lok Sabha by 80 members, Maharashtra sent 48 members, Goa, Manipur, Meghalaya 2 each, and Mizoram, Nagaland and Sikkim 1 each. So the Union Territories of Delhi sends 7 members to the Lok Sabha. So this is the, what we'd call the members for the Lok Sabha from different states. So dear students, we will continue in the next video. Now let us discuss about the qualifications for the membership. So what are the requirement for a member who wants to become the Lok Sabha? So we have here 7 requirements. So let us go one by one. First of all, the person who wants to become the member of Lok Sabha, he has to be an Indian citizen. So the person should be having the Indian citizenship, and only he can be the member of Lok Sabha. But he can get this through the Lok Sabha election, and when he wins in the Lok Sabha election, he becomes the membership. Number 2, he should be at least 25 years of age. And the person who wants to become the member of Lok Sabha, he should be at least having the 25 years of age. Third one, he should have his name in the electoral roll in some part of country. So the person should be having the name in the voting list. Electoral roll means the voting list. Number 4, he should not be an insolvent. Insolvent means he should not be a deputy. Deputy means he should not be with the karzdari. That means he has taken a money from any bank and he has not yet returned it. Then that person who has taken the money from bank or anywhere and he has not returned it before the time, then also he cannot become the member of the Lok Sabha. That means he cannot fight for the member of the Lok Sabha. So he should not be in debt and should have the ability to meet the financial commitments. So he should not be having any what is called the case financially, or he should not have any what is called the debtees. Next, number 5, he should not hold any office or profit under the government. And the person who wants to become the member of the Lok Sabha, then if he is having the any government job, then he has to leave that government job, and then only he is eligible to contest for the member of the Lok Sabha. Number 4 or 6, he should not be a proclaimed criminal, and then he should not be having any criminal record. Number seven, he should not be a unsound mind, and the person should not be physically, we'd call handicapped. So these are the requirement and disqualification of the membership. The Lok Sabha members, in what type of cases he can be disqualified? Let us go through these all points. A person shall be disqualified for being chosen as and for being a member of either house of the parliament. First, if he holds any office or profit under the government of India or government of any state by the parliament, but not minister of the union of or for a state. So the person who holds any government job before he becomes the Lok Sabha members and he doesn't leave that government job, then in that case he cannot qualify for the membership of Lok Sabha. Number two, if he is of unsound mind and stands so declared by a contempt court. So if he is found physically handicapped and it is proved by the competent court, then also he will be disqualified. Number three, if he is an undischarged insolvent and if he is